Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Prashant Raman. I have more than 12 years of experience both in academics and industry. I'm currently working at Institute of Public Enterprise, Hyderabad as assistant professor. Prior to this, I was associated with FMS-WISDOM, Banasthali Vidyapith, and with Satyam Computer Services Limited, now known as Tech Mahindra, as relationship manager. So today we will be covering the module Role of Emerging Technologies in Different Industries, Part 1. This module has been divided into two parts. In the first part, we'll be discussing about the importance, roles, and applications of three technologies, that is artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, and big data. As modern marketers, we have entered a world where the number of choices we have in terms of how we do our job is almost endless. The days of traditional marketing are gone, and now we have a lot of options with digital marketing, SEO, SEM, paid, owned, earned, social media, and so much more. This new age of marketing can be extremely overwhelming and confusing if marketers hang on to the old rules of marketing. This is where technology steps in to push us forward. While the 4 P's, product, price, place, promotion, may still be relevant, we can't rely too much on them without knowledge to guide us about the right product, the right place, the right price, and the right way to promote, which is basically why we marketers need technology. Young population today is part of the millennial generation, and it is consumers from this generation who are driving the change towards new communication technologies. Traditional media such as magazines, newspapers, television compete with media such as the internet, texting, mobile phones, social media, user-generated content such as blogs and YouTube, as well as out-of-home advertising such as billboards and movable promotions. Therefore, all the forms of marketing media have been forced to come up with new innovations to remain relevant. Before we move on to the details of specific technologies, we have to first understand the importance of technology for businesses. The first one is communication with customers. In today's busy environment, it is necessary for employees to interact with clients quickly and clearly. Company websites allow customers to find answers to their queries even after the stores are closed. Fast shipment options allow businesses to move products over a large geographic area. And when customers use technology to interact with a business, the business benefits because better communication creates a strong brand image. The next is efficiency of operations. Technology helps a business understand its cash flow needs and preserve precious resources such as time and physical space. Warehouse inventory technologies let business owners understand how best to manage the storage cost of a holding product. With proper technology in place, executives can save time and money by holding meetings over the internet instead of at a corporate headquarters. The third important point is security. Most businesses of the modern era are subject to security threats and sabotage. Technology can be used to protect financial data, confidential executive decisions, and other proprietary information that leads to competitive advantages. Simply put, technology helps business keep their ideas away from their competition. And last but not the least is research capacity. A business that has the technological capacity to research new opportunities will stay a step ahead of its competition. For a business to survive, it must grow and acquire new opportunities. The internet allows a business to virtually travel into new markets without any substantial cost or the risk of creating a factory abroad. We will now discuss the first technology, that is artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence, AI, is an area of computer science that emphasizes the creation of intelligent machines that work and react like humans. It refers to the intelligence showcased by machines and empowers machines to think about, respond to, and perform tasks like humans. It also helps machines learn from experience and adjust to new input. Today, artificial intelligence is a very popular subject that is widely discussed in the technology and business circles. Many experts and industry analysts argue that AI is the future, but if we look around, we are convinced that it is not the future, it is the present. With the advancement in technology, we are already connected to AI in one way or the other, whether it is Siri, Watson, or Alexa. The technology is in initial phase and more companies are investing resources in machine learning, indicating a robust growth in AI products and apps in the near future. Let us look at some of the applications of AI that are frequently used by customers and companies. The first one is Siri. Everyone is familiar with the Apple's personal assistant Siri. She is the friendly voice-activated computer that we interact with on a daily basis. She helps us find information, gives us direction, add events to our calendars, helps us send messages, and so on. Siri is a pseudo-intelligent digital personal assistant. She uses machine learning technology to get smarter and better able to predict and understand our natural language, questions, and requests. Then there is Alexa. Alexa's rise to become the smart home hub has been somewhat spectacular. When Amazon's first instituted Alexa, it took much of the world by storm. However, its usefulness and its uncanny ability to decode speech from anywhere in the room has made it a revolutionary product that can help us search for information on the web, schedule, shop, appointments, set alarms, and even help power our smart homes. The next one is Tesla. Now, if you're not aware about Tesla, then you have no idea what you are missing. This is quite possibly one of the best cars ever made. The car has not only received many accolades, but because of its predictive capabilities, self-driving features, it is a sheer technological brilliance. Then we have Cogito. Cogito is quite possibly one of the most powerful examples of behavioral adaptation to improve the emotional intelligence of customer support representatives that exist in the market today. The company is a fusion of machine learning and behavioral sciences to improve the customer interaction for phone professionals. This applies to millions upon millions of voice calls that are occurring on a daily basis. The next is BoxEver. BoxEver is a customer intelligent and personalized marketing platform for the travel industry. The BoxEver solution enables customers like airlines and online travel agencies to capture, analyze, and act on large volumes of data about customer behavior in real time to create stronger, more profitable customer relationships. The company's custom analytics engine delivers insights into how each traveler searches, shops, and books travel by synthesizing customer data from multiple repositories such as booking systems, web analytics, mobile activity, and even third-party sources such as social profiles. With these insights, its personalization platform allows travel companies to segment and target each customer individually in real time and deliver tailored, personalized marketing messages and offers across any communication channel. Then we have Nest. Nest, the learning thermostat, was acquired by Google in 2014 for $3.2 billion. The Nest learning thermostat, which can now be voice controlled by Alexa, uses behavioral algorithms to predictively learn from your heating and cooling needs, thus anticipating and adjusting temperature in your home or office based on your personal needs. Companies like Amazon, Netflix, and Pandora are using AI to their full advantage. Amazon's transactional AI is something that's been in existence for quite some time, allowing it to make huge amount of money online. With its algorithm refined more and more with each passing year, the company has become very smart at predicting what we are interested in buying based on our online buying behavior. Similarly, Netflix provides highly accurate and predictive technology-based customer reactions to films. It analyzes billions of records to suggest films that you might like based on your previous reactions and choices of films. This technology is getting smarter and smarter by the year as the dataset grows. Pandora's AI, on the other hand, is quite possibly one of the most revolutionary technologies that exist out there today. They call it their musical DNA. Based on 400 musical characteristics, each song is first manually analyzed by a team of professional musicians based on some criteria, and then system recommends songs that would otherwise go unnoticed, but that people inherently love. We will now move on to the next technology, Internet of Things, IoT. Internet of Things is an ecosystem of connected physical objects that are accessible through the internet. IoT is a giant network of connected things and people, all of which collect and share data about the way they are used and about the environment around them. The Internet of Things is actually a pretty simple concept. It means taking all the things in the world and connecting them to the internet. This includes an extraordinary number of objects of all shapes and sizes, from smart microwaves, which automatically cook your food for the right length of time, to self-driving cars, whose complex sensors detect objects in their path, to wearable fitness devices that measure your heart rate and the number of steps you have taken that day. Then use that information to suggest exercise plans tailored to you. To understand the importance of AI better, imagine you wake up at 7 a.m. every day to go to your work. Your alarm clock does the job of waking you just fine. That is until something goes wrong. Your metro is cancelled and you have to drive to work instead. The only problem is that it takes longer to drive and you would have needed to get up at 6:45 a.m. to avoid being late. And say suppose it is raining heavily, so you will need to drive slower than usual. A connected or IoT-enabled alarm clock would reset itself based on all these factors to ensure you go to work on time. It could recognize that your usual metro is cancelled, calculate the driving distance and travel time from your alternative route to work, check the weather and factor in slower traveling speed because of heavy rain, and calculate when it needs to wake you up so that you are not late. And if it is super smart, it might even sync with your IoT-enabled coffee maker to ensure your morning coffee is ready when you get up. Interesting, right? Now let us talk about some of the more specific implications of IoT. The first one is smart homes. When we talk about IoT applications, smart homes are probably the first thing that we think of. With our AI home automation, you can switch on the air conditioning before reaching home, or switch off lights even after you have left home. You can unlock the doors to your friends for temporary access even when you are not at home. Smart homes has become the revolutionary ladder of success in the residential spaces, and it is predicted smart homes will become as common as smartphones. The second is wearables. Wearables have experienced an explosive demand in markets all over the world. Companies like Google, Samsung have invested heavily in building such devices. Wearable devices are installed with sensors and softwares which collect data and information about the users. This data is later pre-processed to extract essential insights about user. One of the most fascinating examples of wearable is the Guardian glucose monitoring device. The device is developed to aid people suffering from diabetes. It detects glucose levels in the body using a tiny electrode called glucose sensor placed under the skin and relays the information via radio frequency to a monitoring device. Another great application of IoT is in the development of smart cities. Smart city is a powerful application of IoT, generating immense curiosity across the globe. Smart surveillance, automated transportation, smarter energy management systems, water distribution, urban security, and environmental monitoring all are examples of Internet of Things applications for smart cities. IoT will help solve major problems faced by the people living in cities like pollution, traffic congestion, and shortage of energy supplies, etc. Products like cellular communication enabled smart billy trash will send alerts to municipal services when a bin needs to be emptied. Let's take an actual example of smart city. Palo Alto. Palo Alto, San Francisco is the first city of its kind that took a whole new approach towards traffic. They realized most cars on the streets go around and round the same block in search of parking spots. That's the main reason for traffic congestion in the city. The sensors were installed at all the parking spots around the city. These sensors pass the occupancy status of each spot to the cloud. It can guide the drivers through the shortest route to an open spot. The area of agriculture has also witnessed the application of IoT. With the continuous increase in the world's population, demand for food supply is rising continuously. Governments are helping farmers to use advanced techniques and research to increase food production. Smart farming is one of the fastest growing fields in IoT. Farmers are using meaningful insights from the data to yield better return on investment. Sensing for soil moisture and nutrients, controlling water usage for plant growth, and determining custom fertilizers are some of the simplest uses of IoT. There are other numerous possibilities in this field. One of them is a smart greenhouse. A greenhouse with embedded devices not only makes it easier to be monitored, but also enables us to control the climate inside. Sensors measure different parameters according to the plant requirement and send it to the cloud. It then processes the data and applies a control action. The next is smart retail. The potential of IoT in the retail sector is enormous. IoT provides an opportunity to retailers to connect with customers to enhance the in-store experience. smartphones will be the way for retailers to remain connected with their consumers even out of store. Interacting through smartphones and using beacon technology can help retailers serve their customers better. They can also track consumers' path through a store and improve store layout and place premium products in high traffic areas. Healthcare has witnessed a huge investment in IoT. Connected healthcare is at the nascent stage of the Internet of Things applications. The concept of connected healthcare system and smart medical devices bears enormous potential not just for companies but also for the well-being of people in general. Research shows that IoT in healthcare will be massive in coming years. IoT in healthcare is aimed at empowering people to live healthier life by wearing connected devices. The collected data will help in personalized analysis of an individual health and provide tailor-made strategies to combat illness. Now we come to the last technology of this two-part module, that is big data. Big data is a term that describes large volume of data, both structured and unstructured, that is received by the business on a day-to-day basis. Big data is used to describe a collection of data that is huge in size yet growing exponentially with time. In short, such data is so large and complex that none of the traditional data management tools are able to store or process it efficiently. Look at the amount of data that some of the big establishments generate. The New York Stock Exchange generates about 1 terabyte of new trade data per day. The statistics shows that 500 plus terabyte of new data gets ingested into database of social media site Facebook every day. This data is mainly generated in terms of photo and video uploads, message exchanges, putting comments, etc. A single jet engine can generate 10 plus terabytes of data in 30 minutes of flight time. With many thousand flights per day, generations of data reaches up to many petabytes. So when we talk about data, huge in size, it is actually gigantic. So why companies are embracing the big data? Data in today's business and technology world is very vital. The big data technologies and initiatives are rising to analyze this data for gaining insights that can help in making marketing strategic decisions. Utilizing big data solutions in processing digital data is one of the enabling managers or organization and business owners to make quick, informed decisions that streamline efficient business operations. The first use of big data is in cost reduction. Big data technologies such as Hadoop and cloud-based analytics bring significant cost advantages when it comes to storing large amounts of data. Plus, they can identify more efficient ways of doing business. The second is big data helps in faster and better decision making. With the speed of Hadoop and in-memory analytics combined with the ability to analyze new sources of data, businesses are able to analyze information immediately and make decisions based on what they have learned. The third importance of big data is in the development of new products and services. With the ability to gauge customer needs and satisfaction through analytics, more companies are creating new products to meet those unmet customer needs. And then, big data plays a crucial role in better analytics. Grid data platform processing tools like Apache Kafka have made the analytics of vital data instantaneous. A business can gain instant insights into certain customer behavioral trends to enable it to react promptly to avoid losses. So now when we have a brief idea of what exactly is big data and its importance for the business, let us look at some of the real management applications of big data. Technological innovations such as big data have greatly influenced the operations in the healthcare industry. Analysis of big data has boosted the overall efficiency of healthcare service delivery. Both physicians and patients can now interact and analyze the progress of the patient's treatment by checking out the patient's history. The healthcare facilities that have adopted big data-oriented medical devices can now monitor the behaviors of their current and previous clients so as to rationalize better delivery of services that their customers need. For instance, through a watch fitted on the patient's hand, a physician can easily analyze the collected data about patient's heartbeat and temperature and prescribe a medicine without actually visiting the patient. The second important role of big data is in public sector. Several departments in the public sector, such as security agencies and municipalities, utilize big data analytic tools in processing vital data. deceit or fraud recognition, economic or power investigation, environmentally friendly interconnected explorations, and ecological protections are just some of the examples where the public sector has used big data to restructure operations for efficiency. Big data is being used to examine food-based infections and side effects of certain drugs on the general population. Several government bodies use big data analytics to conduct investigations before issuing declarations or making vital public announcements. Another important area is learning. Most learning materials that existed in hard copies are now available as soft copies on various online platforms. Teachers can utilize applications such as Bubble Score in conveying multiple choice tests in a more transparent process that allows the use of mobile device cameras. A data-driven classroom is an easier way of determining what students are learning and what are the most suitable levels of studying certain subjects. The e-learning digital materials are produced through the use of prognostic analytics that enables the producers to merge a lecture plan to a particular student learning needs. Big data is helping the companies in setting the price of the product or services. Big data analytics enables market analysts to study a wide range of market factors and combine the data with companies' account statements to reach the optimal price of a product or service. Another use case of big data is in price optimization, is determining the optimal price cuts to ensure stock clearances. With the help of markdown optimization, companies can determine the optimal price for their products, thus maximizing their profit margin. Another important role of big data is in helping the companies to allocate marketing budgets. Today, businesses have many channels to reach out to consumers, and the entire marketing budget is being allocated to each channel separately. There are significant problems faced by decision makers while determining the optimal budget allocation, as it is very difficult to hold any specific channel responsible for the growth. It is neither possible to boil down to only a few channels, nor decision makers can randomly allocate the resources. Big data offers a solution to this problem using the market mix modeling technique. Market mix modeling provides insights into the current landscapes of marketing activities and the potential future impact of marketing campaigns on ROI, profits, and sales, thus giving you predictive insights about the profitability of campaigns even before the execution. This helps the company to determine the exact channels that have the potential to scale up the profits and invest accordingly. So this brings us to the end of the first part of the module. I hope you have got a brief understanding of how new technologies are helping different industries and making them more sustainable, efficient, and relevant. Thank you. Yeah.